students. Today in this video lecture, I am going to discuss with you the chapter 1 of civics, and the name of the chapter is Indian Constitution. Dear students, when we play any game, we need to follow certain rules according to which it is played. These rules, they define the nature of that game. They also tell us what a player is to follow and what he is not supposed to. Likewise, in our country also, there are some rules and regulations which are followed by all the citizens of the country. These rules or laws are called the basic laws, and all these laws are given in the Indian Constitution. These laws are superior to all the laws of a country. Dear students, our constitution or the Indian Constitution is the lengthiest constitution in the world. It was adopted on 26 November 1949 and it came into force on 26 January 1950. 26 January, as you all know, it is celebrated as Republic Day. Now the question arises, why do we need constitution? Dear children, we need constitution so that our country can be governed properly, to maintain peace and harmony in the country. Second, it defines the nature of the political system of a country, which means as we elect our representative and the representative, they work on behalf of us. So it also defines that what he is to follow and what he is not to. Next one, that it safeguards the interest of the minorities. It also protects the minorities from the dominant groups. Next, as you all know that we have the three organs of the government, it also keeps a check on all these three organs of the government. Now, as you can see here, the picture of the preamble is given. This preamble, it is just an introduction of the constitution. Now we will talk about the key features of the Indian Constitution. We have different key features of the Indian Constitution, and the first one is federalism. Federalism means that we have the government at the different levels, and the levels are center level, state level and local level. Next one, parliamentary form of government. The parliament is supreme and represents the people of the country, which means that the representatives, they are elected by us through universal adult suffrage or universal adult franchise. Next one is separation of powers. The constitution, it demarcates the powers in between of the legislature, the executives and the judiciary. Legislature, they make the laws, the executives, they execute the law, and the judiciary, they uphold the law. Fundamental rights. We have six fundamental rights in our constitution, and these fundamental rights are the right to equality, right to freedom from exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, and the right to constitutional remedies. Now the first right, which is about right to equality, which means that all are equal before the law and no one can be discriminated against his caste, creed, sex, religion, etc. Right to freedom, which means that under this right, a citizen has a right to freedom of speech and expression, the right to form associations, the right to move freely and reside in any part of the country. Next right is right against exploitation. As you can see here, the picture of two children, it is given, and they are just carrying the bricks on their head, which means they comes under the forced labor, and this right, it prohibits trafficking and the forced labor. Next right, it is about freedom of religion, right to freedom of religion, which means that every citizen in India has a right to worship, practice and propagate his or her religion. In the eyes of law, all religions are equal. Our next right is cultural and educational right, which means that every children, they have right to get education, and every community of the society, they have right to just practice their culture. Next right is about the right to constitutional remedies. It means that every people, all the people, they can move to the high courts and the supreme courts if they believe that any one of their fundamental rights have been violated by the state. Now comes directive principles. These principles, they help the government to make social and economic reforms in the country.